day, what I would like to do is just make some candles for outdoors. I had made a couple last year and they turned out pretty nice, and so I thought I'd try it again this year. What I had made last year are candles for repelling insects. Now I'm not so sure how well they work, but I like that they're homemade and they do smell nice. And you can experiment with your own combination of scents. So the first thing that we'll need is some wax. Now this is natural soy wax. And it's microwavable. It makes it very easy to make these candles. So this is soy wax chips. And this is a 1 pound bag. To use a glass one, but I only had this plastic one and I thought it was a good size and good for pouring the wax. Okay. And we'll also need some wicks. I have two different lengths. Oh, I thought that I did. Maybe they're the same length. They might be a different diameter or thickness. Size these are, but you can cut the length of the wick so that it fits whatever container you choose. Okay. And we'll also need your additives for the candle. So these are some essential oils. So you can mix and match different oils because I want this to be more of a bug repellent candle, and I don't have any citronella essential oil. So So I'm just going to be picking a combination of some of these oils that are known to help repel insects. This is one container that I'd like to use. This is not meant to be for candles, so I'm not sure how it will turn out, but it should be fine. I walked past this little planter at the store. It's meant to be for a plant. Little drain hole down there. This is a rose planter, and I thought it looked like the perfect size for a pretty little candle for outside. So that's one that I'll be using today. This one here is also not meant to be for a candle, obviously. And what is this for? It's a mini casserole. This is a mini casserole stoneware. This is from the Pioneer Woman line that they have at Walmart. So I guess you're meant to bake something in this, but I thought it looked like a perfect little container for another candle. And it was only maybe $1 or $2. And I thought it was perfect because it also has a lid. So that will make a nice pretty candle for outside. Okay, so what I want to do first is just measure out how much wax I'll need to fill these containers. Okay, so let me just get these little stickers off. First. I'll get that off later. Okay, so I mostly got this one off. I can get all the residual off later. And this one here. Mistake about the price on this one. When I was looking it up, or when I mentioned that it was only a couple of dollars, that didn't seem right to me, so I went and found my receipt, and it was a little closer to $5. It's so cute, tiny little casserole dish. But it'll be nice to have this little lid for the candle. The volume that you need for each dish, I'm just gonna say doubles. I'm not sure exactly how much it comes out to, but you definitely need more than the amount you can fill when it's dry. Going to pour these in here. Time. Our cup of soy wax chips. And we're just going to microwave these chips here. Maybe should have done it in separate portions. I don't know, but we'll see what happens. Before I start actually making the candles, I do just want to point out that I am absolutely not experienced at all with making candles. I'm not an expert, and this video is totally just for ASMR and relaxation purposes, and I may be doing some things wrong, so for more specific or detailed instructions about how to make these candles, please do your own research. There's lots of things online that you can look up to find out how to do these the right way. Sorry if you're noticing the Band-Aid there. I got a boo-boo. So, first what I need to do is to get these wicks secured into the containers. And there's different ways that people do that. Some people use little special glue dots, I think they're called, that stick right onto the end of that little metal piece there, and it sticks right to the bottom of the container, but I couldn't find those, so I am actually going to be using a hot glue gun, which I've never used before, so we'll see how that turns out. Okay. Alright, so let's see, here I have the glue gun here, and it gets very, very hot, so I'm not going to touch it. Now I have these mini glue sticks, and they are for high temperature, I believe. Just gonna cut these open. So now we just have to give that a few minutes to heat up. So I just need two wicks here. Surface here and be more pause. All right. So now this one here, I was a little bit concerned trying to figure out how I would cover up the drain hole, because when I pour the wax inside the container, I don't want it to spill out in the bottom of the planter. So I was thinking I needed to plug that hole up somehow, but maybe gluing this wick down will help to keep the wax from spilling out. Okay, I'm just using this little paintbrush to push it down. Okay, so that one should be right in the center because I knew where the drain hole was. Now let's do this one. Try to guess where the center is. Now I know people get really technical and perfect and exact with this kind of stuff, but so now I have to find out how long I need to let that dry first, but I'm just going to let these sit for a little bit, and then I'll move on to melting the wax. Or so, and then we'll let it get all melted, and then after it's melted, we'll have to let it cool down a little before we put in the essential oils. just going to be using some oils that are recommended for bug repellents. There's a lot of different types that are supposed to be good for that purpose. Many of these right here are supposed to be good for that. So the ones that I had made last year, I really liked the scent. So I'm going to be using that again. I used a combination of lemongrass, which is really nice. I had also bought some lemongrass plants last year, which smelled really, really nice outside. So that one is good. And I will be mixing that with some eucalyptus. I would like more for the lemongrass to be more of the prominent scent, so I'll put more of that in the candles. I think I'll be doing both candles the same, unless I decide to change my mind at the last minute. I do love peppermint. I have peppermint here. I think that that's supposed to be good also for bug repellent. Maybe I'm wrong, I'm not sure. I'm not sure what I would want to mix it with, though. I know lavender, I think, is supposed to be nice and good for repellent also. I also have this sweet orange, which I like a lot. So I could possibly do a combination of the sweet orange and peppermint. So, I don't know, we'll see. So the next step would be to add the essential oils. But first you need to make sure that the wax is cooled down to a certain temperature, because I think if it's too hot, I think the reason is that the oils maybe can evaporate, I think, or maybe just somehow the composition of the oils gets ruined somehow, so it will affect the scent. So there are special thermometers for measuring the temperature of wax, but I couldn't find one specifically for that, so I ended up buying this thermometer, which is for candy making and deep frying. So I just decided that this one would be good for wax. I might be needs to cool down to about 125 degrees, and that's Fahrenheit. Sure if you can see that the reading there. It's still a little bit too hot. Right now. So I'm just going to let it cool a little bit longer before we add the oils. Okay, so now the wax has finally cooled down to the right temperature, and I'm going to stir in the oils. So this is the eucalyptus, and now the amount to add also is something that you'll have to experiment with and maybe look online for some tips, because I'm just kind of guessing here. I didn't realize that my lemongrass in the other brand was empty, so I have this other one here. I don't know if it's as good quality or not. To the containers. Okay, so we'll just pour this in. This one I want to pour slowly because I want to make sure that it's not running out the bottom of the planter here. doesn't seem to be leaking out, so hopefully that glue on there did the trick. Now I may not have enough wax. We'll leave that one like that for now. So now we need to secure these wicks so that they are standing up straight in the center of the containers. Okay, so now to secure these straight in the middle of the candles, people use different things. Usually some sort of pencil or just kind of long utensil. I happen to have these bigger colored pencils, and I thought they would be good because they have these flat surfaces and they won't roll away, and they're a good length. So we just stand it straight up here, and if I can do this right. I'm messing up the candle. I'm supposed to wrap it around the pencil carefully. Be perfect, but that's okay. And same thing for this one here. Didn't do that too good, and I kind of messed up the wax because it started to dry. Alright. Okay, so it's already starting to harden. I know these aren't sitting on here perfectly, but I don't want to mess around with it too much. So now I'm just gonna let these sit overnight, and then we'll finish them up. Okay, so now the candles have been sitting overnight, and they are solid now. So I'm just going to take the pencils out. And they're not perfect, I see. I kind of messed up the wax here because of delay in making them because of the filming. So, and the swan is not really centered. But they smell very nice. The lemon scent is nice and fresh. So now all I need to do is to trim the wicks. I don't know exactly how close I'm supposed to trim it. I'm just gonna do it right about there. A lot of wax on the wick. Not sure how that will affect how it burns. But of course, we're going to find out. Thank you for watching the video today. I hope that you enjoyed it. And like I said, if you are thinking of making candles yourself, you can find more detailed instructions somewhere else, not here. Thank you.